When you consider Hashem as a father, as a mother, he will be next to you.
ברשות מורי ורבותיי, ובדי פרמישו והשם, I see this דבר תורה for the רפואה of my friend מנחם מנדל בן חנה, שלוש ברוך הוא, תן לו ברכה והצלחה, בריאות ורפואה שלי מה כן ירצו. Today we prepare ourselves for Pesach, and it's amazing. Pesach, it's a holiday. We call it Pesach Hagamatzot, Haga Aviv. Pesach has a lot of names. Now, one of the names of Pesach is Passover. It's like jump. So maybe Pesach, it's good that we call Pesach Hagamatzot, because all year we eat hametz, all year we eat bread, and Pesach we eat only matzot, 8 days. So it will be better to call it Hag HaMatzot. It's the holiday of matzot. But why we call it is the holiday of Passover. So I was thinking that really the real Pesach is to feel independent. What does it mean, independent? Independent from the Yetzirah. Independent from the past. And to be independent from the Yetzirah, and the independent not to be attached anymore to Yetzirah, so you have to pass over. You have to go through. So pass over it. So this is Pesach. And Pesach, it prepares you to receive the Torah. It's not possible to receive the Torah in Shavuot if you did not pass over. I mean, if you're still attached with the Hametz, you will never pass over. If you don't pass over all this, you will not prepare yourself to receive the Torah.
To be free.
To be a real free man, the real freedom. So, this is one of the reasons, I think, why we call it Pesach. But, as you know, on Nisan, the month of Nisan, it's a beautiful month. It's the month of, when we talk about Nisan, it's the month that already, I think, Pesach, it's a holiday that everybody is happy. Because Pesach, it's clean. We clean the house, we clean everything. Even if you don't spend Pesach in the house, we go to the hotel Pesach, we clean the house. You know, Pesach, it's symbolic. I mean, we have to be clean. We have to pass over all these bad things. It's something else. We have to be something else on Pesach. It's a preparation for Matan Torah. So, and the inauguration of the temple, 1 year after the Jews left Egypt, exactly 1 year the Jews left Egypt, the 15th of Nisan, the temple, the tabernacle, the Mishkan, was built 1 year after, and it was inaugurated the first day of Nisan. And then the inauguration lasted 12 days. Each day for a prince of a Shevet, of a tribute, they were 12 tribes, they bring a sacrifice for the inauguration of the temple. And don't forget what I'm going to tell you. And during the inauguration of the temple, the two sons of Aaron HaKohen, they die. It's amazing. They died. I mean, can you believe that? It's impossible. I mean, how can you believe? How can the Jews were so happy? The Gemara said that Hashem, he was very, very happy the day of the inauguration of the temple. And that the way the inauguration was, killing, dying two children, two tzaddikim. I mean, can you imagine that? All Jews were waiting for the inauguration of the tabernacle, and then what happened? Wow, the two children of Aaron died. Oh, why they die? Because they made a mistake in the Mishkan. Because they did something that Moshe Rabbeinu did not teach them. He did a kind of sacrifice. They put more fire. It's nothing. I mean, for you it's nothing, but for Hashem it's something. Because for Hashem, you have to do exactly what He gives you as an order. And you cannot decide how to serve Him. He will tell you how to serve me. And you have to serve Hashem the way He wants you to serve Him. So the same, Moshe Rabbeinu, he was a teacher. He teach Torah to the Bnei Israel. So before Moshe Rabbeinu teach Torah to the Bnei Israel, no one could do something before that Moshe teach you what to do. Even that the thought that maybe we have to do this, as long as Moshe Rabbeinu, he did not say that, you are not allowed to do it. This is Torah. Torah tziva lanu Moshe, morasha kilat. But the question is, why Hashem did that? And the week of the happiness, and the month of Nisan, the month that Hashem, He revealed Himself. Here I am. And everybody saw Hashem coming down. And they were, they were so shocking. They were happy. Ah, Baruch Hashem. That means that Hashem forgive us, you know, the Egel, the Avodah Zarah that we did. So everybody was happy. Hop! They heard scream. What? Nadav and Abihu die. And instead of carrying on being happy, they started crying till they buried them. And once they buried them, back to joy.
Back to
the happiness.
Ah.
I mean, why? So you see, I mean, this is the way you do the inauguration of the temple. This is, I mean, and besides, it's Nisan, the month of the happiness, the month of joy. So on one hand, they're happy, the month of Nisan. On the other hand, they're happy because Hashem is going to reveal it to them. They're happy that all Jews, they sent a representative. Each tribute, there is 12 tribute, each tribute sent a representative to bring a sacrifice. They all been accepted, all been written in the Torah. It was fabulous. And in the middle of all this, two children of Aaron die. I mean, Hashem, why you do that? I mean, if they deserve to die, do it after. Do it next month. Or next year. Why now? You know what this is, the happiness of Hashem? The happiness of Hashem can be when there is a simcha, and the happiness of Hashem can be when somebody who can learn something even in a bad way, but that can bring him back to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. I will explain what I mean. Hashem, He wanted to show the Jews that today is your best day. But one thing you should remember, that we can serve Hashem in a normal way, and sometimes we may forget Hashem. So what Hashem do? He sent some problems. So through those problems, it will wake up the person. Like, I have a friend that he don't understand why he has to suffer. Okay, it came from Hashem, but still he has a problem in his conscience. Why Hashem you bring this to me? What I did to you? I believe on you, but you have to carry on believing on you after all what you are doing to me. The answer is, of course. Why? The Melech said, Yasor Yisraniya V'lamavet L'Nitaneli. Sometimes a person, he deserves to die. But what Hashem does so that he will not die, he send him problems, illness, suffering, to be in exile, or to be in jail, or to be blind. All this, why? So that he will live. So, knowing that Hashem, all what he's doing is for my best, so I can only increase my emunah, my kadosh baruch. Because Hashem will not hurt me just for his pleasure. If Hashem hurt me, it's because there must be a reason that I don't know. Maybe the reason is, maybe my time has come to die.
So maybe
my time has come that I should die. So what Hashem did, and Hashem see that I do mitzvot, I do chesed, I do tzedakah, I do teshuva, I push people to do teshuva. So Hashem, he said, he think, well, this man, it's not fair that he should die. But the time has come to die. His time has come to die. So Hashem said, okay, I can exchange his death to suffering. And he will suffer, will go to exile, but he should live. Yaso Yisraniya. So Hashem, he saw that by taking Nadav Abihu at that day of joy, that would shock the Jews. The Jews will understand that there is two ways to serve Hashem. There is a way to serve Hashem in a normal way, when everything is good, when you need nothing, you have everything, you are healthy, you are wealthy, you have a wife, you have children, you have everything. There is a way, and there is another way, even the hardest way, the worst way, if one of the children pass away. Don't forget, you have to serve Hashem. Don't forget. Of course, people, they prefer to serve Hashem when everything is good. But what about if things are no good? Bikurvai HaKadosh. HaKadosh Baruch Hu, exactly at that moment of happiness. You know, it's not only happiness of the Jews. It was as well the happiness of Hashem. Because Hashem, he wants to live with us. He doesn't want to live there. He's bored there. He wants to be with us. So the only way that Hashem, he will be with us, to come here. And in that moment, look what happened to Nadav Abihu. He did die. So Hashem said, well, he died because you have to learn something. And you know what it is, the recompense, the reward that Hashem gave to Nadav Abihu? Because they were the sacrifice. Yes or no?
Yes.
They were the sacrifice. Because through what happened to them, the Jews will learn something. What, you know what Hashem gave them? Their story, it's repeated every Yom Kippur. That means every Yom Kippur, Hashem forgive us because of them. That means they give their life for generations and generations, millions of millions of millions of. Can you imagine where is their place in Olam Haba? Can you imagine where they are? Can you imagine? Can you imagine where? We cannot imagine. It's impossible to imagine. It's impossible to imagine. So now we understand And you know what? Now I would like just to come through what I'm going to tell you. You must know that on Pesach, the temple, the Beit HaMikdash, was inaugurated. So, what's the meaning of the Mishkan, the temple? The Mishkan that was built. Because the Torah said, do me a Mishkan, where, and I will reside on you. So if you will reside on me, what do you need the Mishkan for? It's like, I ask you, come, I invite you to come to my house, and I will sleep in your house. I mean, come to my house, or build me a house, and I will sleep in your house. If you will sleep in my house, why you want me to build your house? Why Hashem you want us to build him a house? For him, but he will resign, he will live where? Among us. So why you need the Mishkan for? Now let's think a little bit. The Mishkan, he was mobile. The Mishkan, it was like a tent that you can go from place to place. You built it, back up, built it, back up, you know. And then, back up, build, put everything in the suitcases, and go from place to place. You know, the Beit HaMikdash, it was symbolic. Look, listen to this. We had Mishkan. Mishkan is tabernacle. Mishkan was a tent. That Mishkan Hashem, that wherever the Jews went in the desert, the Mishkan went with them for 40 years. When they stopped somewhere, up, they built the Mishkan. And then when they had to, I think you saw the, I think we saw the pictures of the Mishkan. It's a big tent, very heavy tent, and the tent was mobile, you know, to take it from place to place, to remind you. And after Shlomo HaMelech, he built the real Beit HaMikdash, that was built with stones, you know, in Jerusalem. What it is the learning from this? To teach you, don't forget, you are the Mishkan. You are the Mishkan. As long as you live, you have to be the Mishkan of Hashem. You have to remember that you are an Olam Hazeh, not permanent. Like this tent, it's not permanent. This tent, you build it, you keep it, you go somewhere else, you take it with you, you go to Australia, you take your tent with you, you know, like the people who live in the desert. They travel with tents. Wherever they stop, they build their tent. So don't forget, Olam Hazeh, you are like in a tent. And the Beit HaMikdash is the symbol of the Olam Haba. It's the real residence. The Beit HaMikdash was built with stones, yes or no? Now, once that Shlomo HaMelech built the Beit HaMikdash, you cannot move it anymore. That's it. Yes or no? But the Mishkan, you can move it. It's mobile. So the Mishkan, it's symbolic. The symbol that we live in Olam Hazeh, Olam Haba, is mobile.
At 120 years.
After 130 years, of course. Of course. And all our work, like the Pekei Avot said, Ha'olam hazeh dumeh leprozdor bifnei ha'olam haba. The Pekei Avot said this word is like a corridor before you go to the palace. They have a beautiful palace and there is a corridor. So this Olam Hazeh is like a corridor before the palace. The palace is Olam Haba. So all our work here in this world, it should be like a work of mobile. I mean, we should, a preparation for the real house, it's Olam Haba. And one thing we should know, one thing, of course, in this Olam Hazeh, I would like just to tell you this. You know, yesterday, a rabbi came to see me yesterday, a big rabbi. And he told me, I don't know, when I pray, I don't feel the tefillah.
Yo no entiendo por qué cuando yo rezo no siento.
I don't feel it. So he told me, I am a rabbi. Why? And okay. I give lectures. Why don't? I told him because.
¿Qué le dije?
Maybe. You started to do a business. Maybe. And you think a lot about your business.
Tal vez porque vos empezaste con negocios y pensás demasiado en los negocios.
And you are a rabbi. And a rabbi, the more you want to be a rabbi, to be close to Hashem, the tzara is very big.
Y si vos sos un rabino, que tenés que servir a Hashem, y el tzara es muy fuerte.
And I told him, it doesn't mean that you should not do business. But maybe your mind is too much in the business more than Hashem.
Yo no te quiero decir de que no hagas negocios, pero tal vez tu mente está más en los negocios que en Hashem.
Okay. So now, this is because the question is, why HaKadosh Baruch Hu, he did not ask us to wait till we go to Jerusalem and we'll build the Beit HaMikdash? Why Hashem want us to build now a Mishkan, a mobile tent? And then we will build the Beit HaMikdash. The reason is, Hashem wants to remind you that we in this Olam Hazeh, we are like an exile. We are mobile. I mean, we should not consider that we're going to live all life here. We have to understand that we are here for a time being. And then, after 120 years, that's it. Be'ezat Hashem. And then, there will be the Mikdash. That was very important for Hashem, Be'emeta, and that could give us an answer. What happened, Nadav Abihu? Why they had to die in the best time of Nisan, the time of the inauguration of the temple, few days before Pesach? Why does this happen? And you know, one of the mitzvah that Hashem gave us, and the Beit HaMikdash was to give Mahatzit HaShekel. The half coin of money of shekel. And Moshe Rabbeinu, he said to Hashem, you want that Jews will bring you half of the shekel? What for? Why half? Why not? Somebody who is rich could give you a million. A poor man maybe does not have. Maybe he cannot give you half shekel. Why? Hashem said, because this money is the expense to pay the expense of the temple. I mean, I don't want only the Jews, rich people bring money. I want everybody, everyone. All Jews, they will share this expense for the temple. And Moshe Rabbeinu still did not understand. Hashem, come on, Hashem. So Hashem did like this. He took a coin of fire and he said to Moshe, like this one. And Rashi said that the coin that Hashem showed to Moshe, it was a coin of fire. What it is the symbol? Hashem said to Moshe, you know, money, you know the fire. We use the fire only to cook. Or we use fire to make gold. If we want to melt the gold, we have to put it in the fire. This is the symbol. Fire. But don't forget, this money, it can burn as well. If people don't know how to use it, the money is the fire. It can burn. Of course, the money is good. But only when you feel you are the boss of the money. If you will tell the money what to do. But if the money tell you what to do, that can burn you.
Por supuesto que es bueno tener dinero. El tema está de que vos seas el dueño del dinero y que no el dinero se convierta en tu dueño. Que vos sepas qué hacer con el dinero y que no el dinero te diga vos qué es lo que tenés que hacer.
And that was very important. That Hashem said to Moshe, Moshe, I want people to know the only way to be Mishkan, the only way to be a Mishkan, a real temple for me, because every Jew it should be a Mishkan when they are strong, when they feel that they are not under the influence of the money, that they can do anything they want with the money. That's what Hashem wanted to show the Jews. You see, the Beit HaMikdash is everything. Beit HaMikdash is the man. I am Beit HaMikdash. I am Beit HaMikdash. You are Beit HaMikdash. Ah, but if I want to be a Beit HaMikdash, I have to be a Beit HaMikdash. Hashem needed to teach what it is. How can a man can build himself as a Beit HaMikdash? First, make sure that the money is not your boss. You are the boss of the money.
Para que vos realmente seas el HaMikdash, tenés que estar seguro de que vos sos el dueño de tu dinero y no tu dinero tu dueño.
Second, don't forget, Beit HaMikdash, not only if you want to be the Beit HaMikdash of Hashem, you must not only the good thing that Hashem is doing to you, only through this you can be connected to Hashem. Even through bad things, you should know that sometimes through bad things a man could be closer to Hashem. That's why when somebody passes away, we go to his house. Now, like Shlomo HaMelech said, Tov lalechet levet ha'evel, melechet levet ha'mishti. If you have a choice, where to go? To do a mitzvah, a brit milah, a wedding, bar mitzvah, or a pidyon haben, or you have a funeral. What mitzvah you have to choose? Shlomo HaMelech said, the best mitzvah that you should choose, don't go to the brit milah, don't go to the bar mitzvah, don't go to a wedding. Don't go to the pidyon. Go to the place where there is a why, because there you can learn. But there it's what am I going to learn? It's I want to be happy. Yes, you must know to serve Hashem through good things, through bad things. It's hard, but this is the truth. I'm telling you something. A lot of people did the teshuva when they do this. I'm telling you. This sometimes that make you you know, one day there is a man who told me, Rabbi, I am in the army. I saw a lot of my friends die near me, and it doesn't mean nothing to me. Like the Chevra Kadisha. Yeah, I'm not scared. You see every day. There is somebody who told me in Ashdod that he washed more than 100 soldiers during the, you know, the war of,
in Gaza.
No, the war in Lebanon, you know,
Lebanon.
4 or 5 years ago, over 100 soldiers. And he told me, I told him, what did you feel when you saw all those bodies? He said, it's nothing, it's my duty. It's my duty. He doesn't feel nothing. But Hashem, really, Hashem, he wanted the week of Nisan, the week of happiness, the month of happiness, this best month of happiness of Hashem, happiness of the Jews. Hashem, he declared, he showed the Jews there is another way to serve me. Of course, we don't want that. We prefer that. But at least we should know. If you know, it's very good. Because Hashem, anyway, he will not bring bad things to the Jews if everybody is correct. If we are correct, we don't have to worry. Nothing. So Be'ezat Hashem, you have nothing to worry. Nothing. And all this that I'm telling to you, Be'ezat Hashem, that all what I'm telling, nothing will happen to you. Be'ezat Hashem. It, all what I say to you, that should be, this is the tikkun, it should be the contrary. Be'ezat Hashem with you, only Akash Hu will only show you good things, and good things, and good things, and good things, and not Hashem Shalom, that something bad will happen to you, that we have to learn this from God forbid. No. That's what I'm telling you. I'm telling you this to give you the bracha, that Be'ezat Hashem, all what I'm telling you, is just that all this will be the contrary. It's like, because anyway, for me, the Gezerah is off because of the Galut, because of the exile where you are, far away from your family, and everything. And now I would like to tell you one day Rabbi Chaim Pinto, Alav Shalom, my grandfather, is a beautiful story. One day Rabbi Chaim Pinto, just to tell you how much Rabbi Chaim Pinto was disconnected from this world. Sometimes, a lot of times, I want to think maybe I want to match him, and then I realize that I'm far away from him. I'm far away. I don't know. Rabbi Chaim Pinto, Alav Shalom, he was the father of all poor people in Isawira. And even the poor people of Marrakesh used to come to consult him and to ask from him a charity for the poor people of Marrakesh. And he never said no.
Mucha gente pobre de Marrakech también venía y jamás le dijo que no.
And Rabbi Chaim Pinto Alav Shalom, one night,
una noche,
he couldn't sleep.
No pudo dormir.
And he woke up and he started walking the house.
Y comenzó a caminar por toda la casa.
And his wife, she told him,
la mujer le preguntó,
why don't you sleep?
¿Por qué no dormís?
So he said, because I don't know what happened.
Porque no sé qué pasa.
Tell me, did you touch my pocket?
Decime, ¿vos me tocaste mi billetera?
She said, yes, I took some money to buy food for tomorrow.
Yo tomé plata para comprar comida para mañana.
So he told her, now I understand why I cannot sleep.
Ahora entiendo por qué no podía dormir.
Because that money doesn't belong to me.
Porque esa moneda, esa
ahora, it belongs to poor people.
Porque ese dinero no pertenece a mí, sino que pertenece a la gente pobre.
And I never keep my own money in the night. But I only keep money that is belong to me.
Yo solamente puedo conservar la dinero que es mío.
So now he said, give me back the money. And she gave him back the money, and he went to sleep. When when I heard this story from my father, Alav Shalom, I said to myself, when we don't have money, we cannot sleep. When we have everything, so then we can go to sleep.
Cuando tenemos mucho dinero, entonces ahí podemos dormir.
And Rabbi Chaim Pinto Alav Shalom, he saw things the other way. When he had money, he couldn't sleep. When he had no money, he went to sleep.
Y su abuelo era totalmente al revés. Cuando tenía dinero, no podía dormir, y cuando no tenía dinero, dormía.
So I understand from this story that Rabbi Chaim Pinto Alav Shalom,
que mi abuelo,
he saw on the money,
veía el dinero,
like he was the boss of the money.
Que vos tenías que ser el jefe de tu dinero.
Because if the money was his boss,
si
the money will burn him. And if he burn him, will not sleep.
Si el dinero es tu jefe, terminas incendiándote, entonces no puedes dormir.
So Rabbi Chaim Pinto switch off the fire of the money to become himself a fire.
Hizo un switch entre el fuego del dinero y su propio
fuego. Incredible, and now the best of this shiur now is what I want to tell you now. It's a little bit Kabbalah, what I'm going to tell you. It's a little bit Kabbalah. And but it's good to know that. It's good to know that. Something incredible. You know, Hashem has a lot of names. And whatever you see in this world, he has a stamp of Hashem. It is a mark. There is Hashem everywhere. Whatever Hashem he created with one of his names. I'm not allowed to tell you a lot of things. Like, there is one name that El Adnut. There is two names of Hashem that they give light on the Asiya. Asiya, that means Asiya is Olam Asiya. Olam Asiya is the world that we see. You see now. It's like the tree. It was made. There is tree or there is no tree. If there is no tree, there is no tree. But if there is tree, so this tree, if he is alive, because Hashem give him life from two of his names.
Puede haber árboles o puede no haber árboles. Si hay árboles, fue creado por Hashem bajo uno de sus nombres.
It's incredible. It's incredible. So all what Hashem is created. He has his own name. So I was asking, so even Olam Hazeh, even Olam Haba, the other world, there is, as we created the other world with other names. So I asked myself one question. Why Hashem he needed to use a lot of his names to create the world? Why did he not use only one name of his name to create everything? We needed a lot of names. Why? Each name, he give light, he maintain something. Why Hashem did die? That? Why? HaKadosh Baruch Hu asa shekod davar shebara yibo shem ishimutav shemi'er bo. Ma hasiba? Lama HaKadosh Baruch Hu lebara את כל העולמות בשם אחד? למה כל דבר? מה הסיבה? Did you understand the question? Why did Hashem needed to create every individual thing with separate name?
¿Por qué Hashem creó cada cosa con un diferente nombre y no todas las cosas con un solo nombre?
Look at the man.
Mira el nombre.
We have a heart. The heart. And the heart, there is, how do you call it? Les artères.
El corazón tiene arterias.
Les artères. And there is few artères. If one is blocked with grease,
si una se bloquea,
so you have other artères that they can function. But God forbid, if all of them are no good, so it's a heart attack.
Una sola se bloquea, las otras pueden funcionar. Si se bloquean todas, tienes un ataque cardíaco.
And don't forget this, that the heart is the king of the blood.
El corazón es el rey de la sangre.
From the heart you have all veins. It gives blood to the other veins. So life, it's depend of the heart, of the heart, les artères.
Vida proviene justamente del corazón, que de la sangre de todas las órganos.
So, can you imagine, even the heart gives to the brain, and the brain gives to the... I mean, there is a connection. There is a big connection. And Hashem is fantastic. If one artery is blocked,
si una arteria es bloqueada,
and the blood cannot enter, so, oh Hashem, there is other arteries who work.
Va a haber otra arteria que funciona.
Now, can you imagine if Hashem will create the world only with one of his name, and the Jews and the world will do Averot sin? It will be a heart attack. Because if we stop the Shefa to come, because through the names of Hashem, the light came to Man Tedor. And if Hashem, there is too much Averot, so we can block the name of Hashem, and then the words will not mention. So Hashem, he decided that he will build the world, each thing with his own, with another name. So if there is a blockage here, the other is open. It's fabulous. It's fabulous.
Si hubiese creado todo el universo con un solo nombre, si hubiese habido un Averot en uno, sería un bloqueo total en el nombre de Hashem de todo lo creado por Hashem. Si lo crea con distintos nombres, bueno, uno puede reemplazar al otro como las arterias en una plaza.
אם היה השם אחד, אם יחטא העולם, כל העולם יחרב. העולם חסד יבני, שהיא סיתמה, משהו סתום, כאן איש אור שעובד למקום אחר, ובינתיים העולם מתקיים. ולכל בריאה ובריאה יש לה אור המאיר לה. כמו שיש לאדם, גם החברים של סגילים, וכל איבי וגיד הוא נפרד, והדם, הוא מחבר אותם, אבל ברוך השם, אין כל כך סכנה אם נסתם מקום אחד, אחד טיפול יזרום, בו אדם, שוב, אבל אם, חס ושלום, יישק מקום אחד שממנו עובר, אדם, אם יסתם אותו מקום, הכל יחרב. It's incredible. Can you imagine how many members and vein there is in the body. It's incredible. With the blood, you know, for the circulation of the blood. Can you imagine the way, if this one is blocked, the other one, you can use the other one. So HaKadosh Baruch Hu did. He did that, like, El Adnut Me'ir Be'olam Ha'asiyah, כמו שכתוב בספר ישעיהו בפרשת יתסיסה. ממש, ממש. איי, איי, איי. What I would like to tell you is, have you seen your fingers? It's round. The eyes are round. The ears, it's round. The mouth is round. The tongue is round. The heart, the liver, everything is round, 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 round. All the galaxy is round. The sun is round. The moon is round. All the planet are round. The sand is round. Everything is round. Your foot is round. Everything is round. Why? Wherever you go, it's round, 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 round. Everything is round. You take a vein, it's round. You take a member, it's round. You know why? Hashem wants you to know that before Hashem created the world, there were no place where to create the world, because Hashem is everywhere.
No había lugar porque
Hashem is everywhere, everywhere, everywhere. So you know what Hashem did? He did a tzimtzum. It's like, if I want somebody to sit with me in this chair, what I do? I push myself, you know, I push myself, you know, so I can let you sit next to me. So we can sit. But if I don't push myself, where can you sit? Nowhere. So how can Hashem create his world while he is everywhere? So Hashem, he pushed himself and he left a room, an empty side. It was circle, and that place he left it, and that place Hashem built the worlds, all the galaxy, all the planets, and how much big it is, that place that Hashem left to build his world, is like a grain of sand for him. It's nothing. Can you imagine who is Hashem. You cannot imagine. You cannot imagine who is Hashem. Hashem, we want you to know, wherever you are, in the desert, in the bathroom, in your room, in the street, in your business, when you see anything is around, you think of Hashem. If Hashem did not push himself in the sides to create this space to build his world, you will not be there. And I would like to tell you this, Mamash. Every time when you see this circle, think, God forbid, that I will not cause through my averot, through my sin, that I will close an artery. That the light of Hashem will not, I will cause that the light of Hashem will not enter the circle light in this olam. Because this olam is circle. The light of Hashem is like, there is the 10 spherot there, and we are in the middle. Everything is circle. If the spherot are circle, there is 10 igulim. And in each circle, on each sphera, it has 10 spherot, 10 igulim. So altogether, how many there are? 100 circles. 100 circles from where the light of Hashem come to give the world Shefa, abundance, life, happiness, bracha, etc., etc. When God forbid there is klal in the world, because some of those pipes are blocked from Averot, and the or doesn't circle. It doesn't go where it should go. So it's blocked, stopped. So Baruch Hashem, there is tefillah. When we pray, when we do teshuvah, we open them. Especially, Hashem, give you a chance to be a Mishkan, to be His Mishkan. He wants to live on you. So automatically, if you become the Mishkan of Hashem, so through you, it will be this all this circulation of the Shefa of HaKadosh Baruch Hu. And you, of course, you delivered the Shefa from Hashem to you, to the world. It's incredible. Now this is the parash of the week. V'asu li mishkan v'shachati betocham. This is the HaKadosh Baruch Hu said, hey, David, I don't need you to be the Mishkan, my Mishkan. The world is my Mishkan already. But I want a Mishkan in the middle of a Mishkan. I want you to be my permanent house. The world, you see the world in front of your eyes, yes or no? If you see the world in front of your eyes, that means this world is, there is Hashem there. But Hashem said, I know I am in this world because I met in the world. If the world is melted because I am there, but I want to be, it's like the man is like the Kodesh HaKodashim. You have the Mishkan, and which it is holy, and you have the Kodesh HaKodashim. The Kodesh HaKodashim is the real holy place. It's like you have a body, you have the heart. The heart is the Kodesh HaKodashim. This is Eli Pukudah Mishkan Aidut. These are a question in the parash of this week. The Torah said, this is the way, this is the calculation of the Mishkan of the Torah. Why twice Mishkan? Why the Torah said twice Mishkan? It's like I call you David. Hey, David. This is the calculation of the house of David. The house of David. Twice. Why? Hashem wants you to know. Hey, don't forget. I am already in the world. because all this world is like a Mishkan. But the real Mishkan that I want is you. Anyway, I am here anyway. But I want you to be my house. It's like you go to Paris, and all people in Paris, they invite you, and you say, no, I want to go to see David Pinto. I choose David Pinto to be in his house. Hashem, he has all this world where he can be. No, he wants the house of man. Of Menachem Mendel, he wants to be with him. He wants to live with him. He wants to give him happiness. He wants to give him life. He wants to give him joy. He wants to give him everything. That's what Hashem wants. Understand? It's fabulous, fabulous. Now you see this igul, this circle that you see everywhere. Not to forget it. This ego to remind you how much we depend on Hashem and how much Hashem depends on us as well. Did you see that in the month of Cheshvan there is no holiday? Nothing. Kislev, this Chanukah, Teved, there is we fast, Shvat, to Mishvat. Adar is Purim, Nisan is Pesach, Iyar, there is there the Hilula of Rabbi Meir Bar Nes, Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai. Iyar is the month of preparation to Matan Torah. Sivan is Matan Torah. Tammuz was the Beit HaMikdash there is an event that happened in Tammuz. Av the Beit HaMikdash was destroyed. Ilu is the month of Teshuvah. Tishri is Sukkot, Rosh Hashanah, Kippur. But Heshvan, nothing. It's incredible. Nada, nothing. You know, I was thinking, well, there is nothing in this month. Why? Because this month is right away after Tishri. After Rosh Hashanah, Kippur, Sukkot. I mean, after Rosh Hashanah, Kippur, Sukkot, there is nothing. I mean, Hashem, he filled us with joy, with teshuvah, with faith. Hashem, he wants us to carry on. That Mashiach should come. That Hashem, he wants that when Mashiach will come, all the month to come, there will be nothing there. Anyway, it's a new life.
Que viene después de Sukkot, de Rosh Hashanah y Yom Kippur. Entonces lo deja libre para que venga el Mashiach, para que realmente nos demos cuenta que tenemos que empezar una nueva vida.
It's like somebody that is in the hospital. As long as he's in the hospital, well, that means that there is a problem. Once he's out of the hospital, Baruch Hashem, he's okay now. So Cheshvan is the motto, he's okay. He did nothing. Baruch Hashem. So if it's okay, so Mashiach should come. It's incredible. And I would like just to tell you this, please. You see Noah. Hashem show Noah, you know, the keshet. How do you call it? L'arc-en-ciel. You know, when it's raining, you see the sky.
Arcoiris.
L'arc. L'arc-en-ciel. And Hashem said to Noah, you see, when I am angry against people, I will not destroy the world. I will see this ark, and I will not and this ark is circled.
Hashem le dijo a Noah, cuando yo esté muy enojado y quiera destruir el mundo, no voy a destruirlo, sino que te voy a mostrar el arco y dice el arco es un círculo.
And the question is, why Hashem is showed to Noah something circled? Because Hashem said to Noah, Noah, if people they don't follow the steps of Hashem, so I have to destroy the world because through the Abel they stop the Shefa, the Malite to go to enter the circle to come to the world. That means that people did not feel me, and there is everything in the world to make like the earth, it's circle, everything is circle. I mean, said it to make you feel, to make you remind you of Hashem who created you. And if you don't do that, so Hashem is angry. So instead of destroying the world, so Hashem just bring this circle, this arc, to demonstrate his anger, but he will not destroy the world. Now you understand why everything that Hashem created, there is one of his names.
Para entendieron por qué todo lo que Hashem creó tiene cada una, cada cosa su nombre, un nombre distinto de Hashem.
Baruch Hashem, Hashem created the world with a lot of arteries.
Gracias a Dios, Hashem creó el mundo con muchas arterias.
Like the heart.
Como el
corazón. He has a lot of arteries. When one is closed, the others carry on,
meeting
the man living. And I would like just to finish this. But if, God forbid, Hashem will create only one artery in the heart, if there is something, heart attack, and he dies. So Baruch Hashem, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, he put his names in each Olam, Abiyah Olam Odri, is four words. Atzilut, the glory. Bria, the creation. Yitzira, Asiya is the fabrication. The creation, the fabrication, and the. It's like this watch. Before you do the watch, you imagine the watch, then you design the watch, then you fabricate the watch, and then here's your watch. The Hesed le'Avraham, Rabbi Avraham Azula, he said that Hashem, he created Adam Kadmon, a man with a, and through this man that we cannot see him. And through this man, Hashem put all the ten spheres on him. And from Hashem to that man, Kadmon, there is the circulation of the life of Hashem. And of course, the more you serve Hashem, the more the world is meant. So, Be'ezat Hashem, this Dvar Torah, it's for the bracha, for the Hatzlacha of Menachem Mendel, Shehakadosh Baruch Hu ten lo Bri'ut, Parnasa Tova, and Bracha v'Hatzlacha, and I pray to Hashem and that he will take this present from my hand, that he will put it back in his permanent office, Be'ezat Hashem. And I pray to HaKadosh Baruch Hu to give you all what you need, Be'ezat Hashem. And as you know, I know that you love the Torah, we all love the Torah, and Be'ezat Hashem, HaKadosh Baruch Hu will give you a long life, and bracha, v'atzlacha, and bri'ut, and this Dvar Torah that I said, a 1 hour of Dvar Torah, will give you strength, Be'ezat Hashem, and Eichut Yamim, and all bad gzerot will be finished.